The next test that I've chosen to demonstrate using the scope is also quite a new evolution, if you like, with the introduction of digital control from sensors, or digital outputs from sensors. The need to convert a digital value to an analogue value. Now, the full importance of this will only become established with the second part of this presentation. It's in two parts. This one is looking at conversion of digital MS meter to an analogue event. And then the second part, which is a separate presentation, is the interpretation of a wideband sensor. And to make it interesting in terms of diagnostic process, I've combined the two, because there's going to be some analysis between the performance of the MS meter and the wideband lambda sensor. That's why we've made two separate presentations, but coming to a joint conclusion. So what are the objectives? To determine type of MS meter under test, converting a digital signal into an analog display, and evaluating its performance. I've got something a little bit special as well in this event, so I'd like to throw a little bit of something in the works. So, I've connected to the... What we've got here is a Skoda 1.8 direct injection engine, fairly late generation engine, with digital air mass meter, which is pretty much run-of-the-mill now with everything. I've connected the probe. Usually the output signal is nearest the engine, not always, but generally speaking, that's quite often the case. So we're dealing with that probe with a reference from the battery negative. We're dealing with a digital signal, so I'm not going to do a close coupled or floating measurement in this case. I'm quite happy to take ground from the battery. And the ignition is on, so we have a value. I haven't done any scaling, I've just simply my home address. If you click on the house, that's where you live, and there's the update. So it's your house, you can put your furniture where you want. I know exactly where my furniture is, and I have a number of ranges. It's free run with a preset time base in the appropriate range of 200 volts. I don't need 200 volts, so we need to scale that. So let's bring the voltage down, say, to 10 volts. Now, the reason I chose 10, most of these digital air mass meters work on a 5-volt range. So a 10-volt scaling is about right. In other words, the scaling of the image is important. Now, what's happened there? That's what they call envelope or compression. Within that is a very high number of events taking place, frequency. The component works off frequency change, not duty. We are going to use that sort of time base later on, but if we wanted to measure specifically frequency, then remember, three time bases, milliseconds, hundreds of milliseconds, and 5 seconds per division. I want to choose 1 millisecond of time, which should give us enough events. Oh, sorry, there we go. Which should give us enough events. I think you'll agree that's quite clear. It's in free run, I'm not using triggers. I want to switch channel 5 off for a moment. Let's leave 5 just out of the equation. We'll come back to 5, that's the little special bit for the end. Right, so we have a... What time base have we got? 1 millisecond per division, 10 milliseconds across the screen. You can see the event is digital, and we need to know what the frequency is. So let's call up the measurements box, add measurement on A, the channel of interest, and we want to call up frequency. Across the whole trace, yes. Apply it, yes. And average frequency is 1 kilohertz, yep, 1.08, just over 1,000 hertz, 1,000 cycles a second. Most of these digital air mass meters increase in frequency with an increase in airflow across them. However, there's an increasing number of them, and I came across it on VAG, which surprised me just last week, that decrease. They start at a high value and come downhill. Generally, it's a French variety that do that. And they also find some of the test capabilities of these air mass meters do also vary. The test I'm going to show you on this car works perfectly. Regrettably, the test I'm about to show you does not work too well on certain types of air mass meter. And I wish I knew the answer, and I don't. So if any of you out there do know it, please tell me. Right, we are going to convert that into an analogue representation. But we need more time, profile. So I'm going to go back and choose 5 seconds per division. That's going to compress. This is envelope. So we've compressed many thousands of events in there. And now I'm going to select this box. At the moment, all the measurements we've made so far have what we call a DC coupling with reference to battery negative. I'm going to open that box where we have a choice of AC, DC, or frequency. We can only do this with one channel. In other words, the computing capabilities limit this test to one channel, so you have to test each digital device singularly. Now that I've got frequency, we need to check range. So I'm going to go for the upper range, which is a 20K range, and we should have a value. Now, because the way the software is written, it now is using full screen. And you can see down here, the zero baseline is here. And this line now, this trace that's being drawn, if I get my cursor and place the cursor on that line and left mouse, channel A, 1.053 kHz. So the measurement now, instead of looking at frequency from the original image, we're now measuring it as an analog representation. So let's run the vehicle and have a look at the trace. And we should be okay to start. Everything's set up. Yes. I'm going to wait until the trace just starts to draw. Start the engine, let it idle. Let it idle for a short while. Check in stability. Maximum attainable RPM with a static vehicle. And engine off, ignition back on. I can't increase the RPM anymore. This is a DSG box. And freeze the image. And let's just move the image up the page a little bit. Not that one. It's a blue image that we're interested in. Let me get that back down to the baseline. Where are we looking? There we are. Right, let's move the blue image up to a central baseline. So, we now have, if you're familiar with an air mass meter, a fairly recognisable output from the air mass meter. Can I use it diagnostically? Well, in its singular format like this, no, but the second part of this presentation, I'm going to bring in the wideband lambda sensor, and we can make some sense of it, and you'll see the reason why I want to convert digital to analog in the first place. And this is some research we've been doing, a long time ago, and we're doing some current research, which is not yet complete, which we'll discuss in a moment. But let's have a look at the event. Can we use this on its own? No, I've already said that. But what we've got here is a representation of frequency as a visual image, looking at the increase in airflow across the air mass meter. But we need to compare it with something. And what I want to compare it to is feedback. In other words, from the wideband sensor, the oxygen sensor, that enables me to prove fuel trim analysis in real time. So, you've seen that test. I like it, I like the accuracy of it, but I did say earlier, regrettably, you don't get that same performance across all digital air mass meters, unfortunately. What I'd like to do now is just switch channel 4 on. Now, channel 4, I've converted from yellow to black. It's black's a nice strong colour. I just like black rather than yellow, so it's a black trace. I'd like to just repeat the test we've just done. And just ignition back on. What are you going to say? Okay, what am I up to? Well, let me just bring this down and do that. Now, if you don't find that interesting, I find it fascinating, because what we're actually doing is the development we've been doing for a number of years. The results are inconclusive across all air mass meters, so I can't produce it as a standard test profile, which is why I don't talk about it too much. It is incredibly accurate on the air mass meters that it does work with, and this is one of them, because what we're actually looking at on the black trace is current flow across the air mass meter. I tell you the really interesting facts with this. Every engine we've tested so far, irrespective of petrol or diesel, irrespective of engine size, produce exactly the same results of current flow. And what we have is around 100 milliamps of current at idle, represented by 1 volt, which is the attenuation of this particular device I'm using. So if I bring that down, 890 millivolts, that's near enough for me. And with about 170 milliamps of current at peak, so if I bring that up to the peak value, it's about there. Current value is 1.636 volts, which is 163 milliamps of current. Every one of them produces the same figure, 100 milliamps, 170 milliamps. With performance software, you get a little change in that, of course, but that is a standard current flow through an air mass meter. There's got to be something in this. I'm trying to develop this test across all air mass meters. I haven't concluded that yet, but we're still working on it. But I think you'll agree that I find this incredibly convincing in terms of the possibilities. But once again, it just proves how accurate an oscilloscope can be in helping assess the true load value across a component, because the air mass meter does use current in part of its functionality in converting the mass of air into a measurable value. And we've converted this from frequency. So we've gone from frequency to analogue, and we've also gone effectively from frequency to current. So there we have it, once again, just demonstrating how powerful an analytic tool the scope can be. That concludes this part of the test. We'll take a short break, because we're going to set up now for the second part, which is a separate presentation looking at wideband sensors.